anything you say or do can and will be held against you in a court of law. You have the right to an attorney. If you cannot afford an attorney, one will be appointed for you. Clarissa Castles, financially excluded and now in jail for a crime. Okay. I just want to know two things. Who is Gaddafi and why are you working with him?
I don't know who, what you are talking about.
Let me paint this picture for you. For the past 3 months, you and your friends have been going around robbing banks, only taking 5 million at each robbery. But last month, you took 5.5 million. What you don't know is that 5 million is nothing, and you can get away with this. But the minute you take just a little bit more, and you get greedy, you stand the test of taking what we call marked money. I know you messed up. And I know you are working with Gaddafi. And I will make sure that you, him, and your little friends rot in jail.
$5.5 million. It's never part of the plan. I mean, I don't even know these girls are okay.
And now, detective, 5 years later, you still haven't caught him. To make matters worse, you are implicating 4 girls. Girls, detective, into this crazy world of yours. You are wasting police department's time, money, and resources chasing a ghost. Just do your job.
5 years ago, the city was up in arms. 4 bank robberies at the end of 4 consecutive months, only taking 5 million. And now 4 girls are doing the exact same thing, and you don't see the connection? I just need a little more time to get to the truth.
You're one of the finest detectives I know, and I would hate to see you lose your job because of this. But if you do not start following protocol right now, I'll be forced to take your badge in.
Captain!
This conversation is over.
Guys, we have to tell the truth.
What?
The truth is the only way, guys.
Hey,
please.
Hey, listen here, Wena. Adelola! Azuma! We are all sticking to one story and we will get out of here, okay?
And how are we going to do that exactly?
Gaddafi!
He said he'd take care of us.
Okay. You're right. I mean, even though, like, none of this makes any sense, we're in this together, okay, guys? I mean, we don't even know who the hell this freaking Gaddafi is, but we did what we had to do, okay? And I just want to graduate.
I actually could not give a fuck about graduating.
I don't give a fuck about graduating.
I'm what?
You're white. There, I said it.
Whether you graduate or you don't graduate,
it's nice to be white. Everybody knows. So whether you graduate or you don't graduate, it's nice to be white.
Guys, please, can we not get into this stupid black and white thing right now and just focus?
Yeah,
we should focus. Focus on the fact that the white girl screwed us over.
You know what?
What? I didn't even want to do this,
but you were so desperate.
Gaddafi made it very clear that he wouldn't help any of us, unless all four of us did it.
Screwed us over?
You should be thanking me! You still screwed us over.
Hello, my friends.
This was easy, guys, okay? Get in, get out, quick! Easy, man! Okay, two at the back, two in front,
who you are. I want want nothing more than for you to embrace all of you, and not just a part of you because you are scared of the nonsensical nonsense of today's society. My daughter, Adelola, I pity you. I really pity you.
I don't know what game you and your little friends are playing, but eventually one of you will crack.
Waste of time. It's a waste. Look at me. secret, can you keep it? Swear this one you save. Better lock it in your pocket, taking this one to the grave. If I show you, they'll know you won't be dead.
You know we're not together
shut
anymore.
Shut up.
You haven't changed. The best is high school. You still think you're better than everyone.
Give me your badge. You are suspended with immediate effect. Even advantage of your title.
I just wanted justice.
Badge! Gaddafi? It's done.
So much potential. Who does he think he is? Mr. Big, important businessman, in his fancy suit and tie. He must think he's so special. He must think he's finally made it. I was the special one. How did I get here?
Something we'll thank them for in the future. They make us attend fixtures. That system then?
Irrespective of how they do it, they make us do things we wouldn't normally do. They forcefully uncover talents that laziness hides. If they didn't force us to do sport, we would all be overweight wimps.
Huh? And is prefecture the only way to instill respect? Some of us are mature enough to understand the importance of authority without the aggression of a prefect body.
But aggression doesn't necessarily mean violence. There's nothing wrong with a little rage here and there stuffing up the school. Would you rather have a school full of scraps or a school that is in water? We are not mature enough to understand our individual impact to the school.
Preach.
Imagine a school that lives on tradition, honor, and excellence suddenly collapsing because of a few people who think that they are higher than the school. Besides, aggression can be seen as a display of brotherhood. Don't you think that that very matric who shouted at us today wouldn't stand up for us against rival schools?
No, that's very foolish.
The respect that we have for each other is the glue that makes our brotherhood unbreakable.
Yeah, this new English teacher's an eight, eh?
Eight? Yo, eh? As my connections would say, Pat's techie is overluck.
Oh. occur. And so, a question of your leadership potential must be asked. The question of whether I can hand over the future of our school to you. Life is a journey. And in the beginning, we're all given a ticket. But most of us end up in economy class. But there's a select few that benefit from the privilege and opportunity of a first-class ride. However, we all face in the same direction, and that is forward, towards the cockpit. So, in the end, we would all like to be pilots, in order to control where we land. As leaders of our school, you are given a little promotion, if you will, to say the role of flight attendant. You are not the pilot just yet, but neither are you a passenger anymore. You are somewhere in between. But some people are slightly more comfortable having a seat for several hours, but your leaders want more control. In short, there are two ways of becoming the pilot. One, by upgrading your ticket. And two, by commanding a position of power that allows you to walk straight in. But a word of warning, when you encounter turbulence in your life, don't leave yourself on autopilot, because that is how you become the one. Good day.
Let's fly this bitch together.
Oh, yeah.
First years of university. Now I apologize if you've heard this little prologue before, but I want you to do something for me. Take a look at the person to your left. Now take a look at the person to your right. Consider this. 5 years from now, 10 years from now, heck, even 30 years from now, odds are the person on your left is going to be a loser. The person on your right, however, also a loser. And you in the middle, well, what can you expect? Loser! Loserhood!
Loser! So, he expects to be like New Zealand in the ICC, eh?
Yaru, complete annihilation. I just wish my boys were there.
This was our year.
Which you can't deny. A.B. de Villiers is a fucking tank!
Green and gold is love!
So I'll check the green mark.
Yeah, see, it's rubbish.
Sure, man. Say, what's your name?
Dom.
Michael.
Cool. Hey.
Okay.
Awesome. Yeah. Okay, go. So, are you laughing, Cape Town?
It's okay, man.
Oh, yeah. Okay, cool. So, are you going to scrummage?
I don't know. Depends how I'm feeling.
Yeah. Maybe I'll see you
Thank you.
big squirrel. Everybody knows water and fire don't mix.
But they each bring their unique attributes into the world.
I was doing him a favor. He went behind my back. We were meant to be in this together. Our prefecture was for both of us, or neither. I told Headmaster Bates, that I didn't want the post. How could he go behind my back and take it, even if I threw it away for him?
Maybe you thought that you wouldn't make it. So you asked the headmaster not to choose you out of pride. It seems to me that Sasha did what was best for him. Because it's so wrong to have someone want to walk their own path instead of the same path as you.
He should be so lucky to have my companionship.
Whatever, man. I'm better go take a leave.
Dominic is wrong. I'm not at fault. They need me to succeed. If they want to walk without me, fine. I will walk alone and leave them to suffer the obstacle they chose. My life was more challenging than his. Changes in my life happened to me. I didn't cause them. So is it really my fault? What did I do wrong? Maybe it's not what I did wrong, but what I didn't do right. I took change to be a fault of life instead of embracing it as a part of life. I want a Garros too. And it's about time I start working for it. I'm not waiting on for my first class ticket. I'm walking straight to the pilot's suite. He didn't take my prefectship away. He got his own. I'm sorry, old friend. I was blinded by silly juvenile whims like jealousy and envy. I should have listened to Dominic. I will no longer be loser cum laude. I realize now the turbulence in my life has been the winds of change. And it's time I take control and pilot through them. Once said, help would always be given. Well, now I'm asking for it.
Sikawuti.
occupy the development of my people? Do I even have a responsibility towards these people? Or am I to enjoy the fruits of my hard work, my labor, and my ambition alone? The winds of change are blowing, urging me to flow. It is time to start this journey and finally let go. Although the road may be uncertain, I will have to walk alone. But my heart will guide me through this. My soul will lead me home.
Mamela!
Africa!
Africa!
Mamela!
See you. here making our country barbaric. Look at them, your hand, eh? Where's your Nelson Mandela now, you peppers? Where's your Oliver Tambo now? They're not gonna come help you now, huh? Fucking peppers.
My children will grow up without a father. I have blood on my hands.
You whipped us like dogs for what? I snorted at my father like a cow!
My name is Mbulelo, Mamisi the Prince, but they call me Mary.
Set us free.
My children will grow up without a father. I have blood on my hands!
You whipped us like dogs for what? I snorted at my father like a cow!
Mary, Mamisi the Prince, set us free.
My children will grow up without a father!
Was the sound of barking dogs. They were rejoicing because they got served. This is the freedom in which I am prepared to die. For as long as I live, I will never bow down to a white boy.
I know that. Chop, chop. When's the galore? The galore's only quizzer. every month to Zuma 1,300 social grant. I'll afford to make Doom spray in it.
No matter, Sisi. It had a man, Manda Dad. Go back to it. Man. Don't miss Sisi. Now your dad, we're thinking of renovating the house. We are born of Sinja. Your hair is very beautiful, but listen. Tomorrow, we're thinking that we could just go check the prices. Just Ama prices, Sisi. Yankel, Ama price. Dad, what
do you think? Send it to my Namaki. Oh, we built it already. Yes.
Speaking about money and prices, currencies, I was thinking you'd just give your brother and your old juices about 300 to wear to computer course.
We are always speaking about prices, renovating the house, and you forget the important things. You know, let's discuss. Sis, when are you getting married? Because Galong told me, sis, your grandfather and I are going to die soon. And these two have disappointed me. No marriage, just children. Don't be
your peace. Speak now or forever hold your peace. His lungs are full of good screams. I know how much it hurts when it happens.
He lay on your bed, soaking your pillows with tears, trying to remember what is it that you fear. Is it the passing of time or the love that you love? Is it the fact that you can't bring back the past? What is it that you fear?
The soul we walk in is pregnant, made fertile by remains of silenced human beings. What the faces mask, the tongues will reveal.
Fear itself is undefined. Is it the people you've hurt or the people that have hurt you? Is it the love of a friend or the passing of a family member? Or is it the fact that your life might end in tragedy? What is it that you are afraid of?
The soul we walk in is threatening. Sensory organs have misplaced themselves. Eyes have turned into ears. The murder is held by the decibel. Speak now or forever hold your peace. 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 Speak now together. Rest in peace. See expression. Expression feels like tiptoeing on a tightrope. It's a thin line between offense and appeasing. Expression is a disease and expression is a cure. It's how we kill, teach, heal, and so much more.
Yes, ma'am. our ears have heard, what our mouths have tasted. Eh? And we will not give up. We will fight. We need to fight for our space in this school.
Yes.
My friends, come on. Are you not with me? Clown and actor in my house! assault, shooting. You know how it goes when the students and the teachers fight. It ends up in chaos.
It won't be like that, I promise, now, please.
Yes, and don't come out. Go be there now. Sort this out as long as it doesn't come in. Who's next time? I want to come out.
Elizabeth! Elizabeth!
Yes, Uncle!
Elizabeth, what's my breakfast? I'm hungry.
Oh, Uncle, see, I'm actually just preparing in the kitchen.
Elizabeth, you're going to be late for school.
Hey, Uncle, I have a problem.
What's wrong, Elizabeth? Are you sick?
Hey, no, Uncle. You know this drama thing that my friends are doing?
Very, very splendid idea, Elizabeth. I like that idea.
Yes, Uncle, you also think so, but our principal is saying that we are causing havoc in his.
Why, Elizabeth?
She said that it's nonsensical and political, and now she
listen to me, Elizabeth. You have the right to say anything or express the way you want, as long as you're not offending anyone.
Yeah, Uncle, I know, but she's saying that if we do not come with our parents or guardians, we can't enter the premises.
No, Elizabeth, I'm late for work. I cannot go to school with you.
Uncle, but if you can't
come. Listen, come here, Elizabeth. You know, Elizabeth, you are my special export, so she's going to allow you to go to school.
But that's not even the case. The case is that I cannot enter special export.
I'm Elizabeth, I'm late. Elizabeth, can we talk about this later? Elizabeth, no. No, Elizabeth!
Uncle, you have to come with me, oh!
Yes, I'm here.
Madam, we have the right to enter that premises, eh?
Rights? What do you know about rights when...
I think
traditional academic methods to explore the same content with sports, music, dance, theater, games, and etc. etc. Madam, we are humbling ourselves before you. Can you just open this gate? Hey, we are begging you. Save yourself some embarrassment.
Everybody wants change. We want change. But we are afraid. I mean, now, today, this is the time. Everybody has seen, heard, and we all can.
We for change.
Really weird lately, you know? It started out with small things. We used to be interested in the same things, you know? We dabbled in a bit of feminist philosophy, the oppressive nature of patriarchy, white cisgendered sexual privilege, the oppressive nature of the struggle faced by the LGBTQI plus community, you know, standard stuff. But they've been acting really peculiar. It started with small things, you know? Like him casually flipping their hair, using hashtag references in real life, but you know what? The straw that broke the camel's back? My friend Gemma, she laughed at a smutsman joke. Not any smutsman, god damn it, he's just so... The other day, I overheard him have a conversation with one of his friends.
Check it.
know I had a back door.
Everyone has a back door.
These days, you have women everywhere starting blogs,
and demanding things.
No! No! Crazy things like equal pay and decent sex lives.
And for what? To what end?
To unravel a societal fabric that has been going on for centuries. All in the name of progress. For progress' sake. Who is this progress?
And what has he done?
You're so right. I don't know. The vaccine? Space travel? The freaking internet? All the patriarchy ever did was ignore half the world's brain power anyway.
Enough. I've had enough of this idle chit-chat. I will now expose my evil plans.
Oh. Underlings, enter! One by one, my glorious henchwomen, Miss T, has bestowed unto them teachings of subjugation and oppression, casting a spell on each of your little friends and turning them into the types of women who would never indulge in wicked female liberation. Soon, I will have taken over the entire residence, the university, and the world. Take it away, Miss T.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Go over there and rip your head, baby girl.
Oh, thank you so much.
Long way to go until happily ever after.
But guess what? We're heading here. to watching your show tonight. I just wished that I did. I mean, where did Lady Jasmine find such beautiful
talent? Oh, I learned from the best. She didn't find me anywhere. I found her.
Of course. I don't doubt that for one single sec. I mean, you seem like the type of girl who always gets what she wants. Wouldn't you say, Prashant?
She's a smashing bird, sir.
Bird.
It's a pet name.
Well, I have a real name, and so do all the other women who work in this business. You just don't know them. And from our perspective, it's you nameless customers that become our pets.
Prashant, apologize, please.
I'm sorry, sir.
Why are you apologizing for it? Who's this wannabe henchman?
He's literally a human accessory.
Buy one, get one free.
Actually, buy.
Oh, look. See, we made friends while we're away.
What car does he drive, Anna?
Such lively personalities. I absolutely love it.
Thank you.
Actually, who are you and what are you doing here?
Well, allow me to put you straight on that. My name is Mr. Black. And this is my assistant, Prashant. And you all are?
I'm Anna. Hannah Mosity.
I'm Lola Diamond.
Julia Rose.
And I'm Lexi Darling.
Such a pleasure to meet you all. I mean, it's not every day you get to meet such talented, beautiful women.
Compliments will take you everywhere, Mr. Black.
So, do you have a first name, Mr. Smooth?
Prashant, would you mind telling Anna my first name, please?
That would be Mr. Sir.
I don't think I got to introduce myself properly earlier. I'm Lady Jasmine's boss, and I'm here scouting for my next show on Broadway.
Did you just say Broadway?
That's right. Producer and director.
Now, I normally don't do this, but after watching your show tonight, I just had to make an exception. I'm giving you all a last-minute offer. You come work for me. You'll get better pay. All travel expenses will be covered. The work is always guaranteed. And you work whenever you want.
Wait a second. What's the catch here, Mr. Black?
I want you all as a group. It's all or it's nothing.
Wait, wait, wait. Mr. Black, is there any chance of a solo contract?
When I say group, I unfortunately mean group. She really learns to listen sometimes.
Well, you should learn to stop being such an asshole.
Mr. Black, how much money are we talking about here?
Lord knows I need the money.
Oh my God, Lexi. If you start crying about your brother and sister again, I will literally stab myself in the face with my eyeliner.
Let me just say this. It's more than enough money to make all your financial problems just disappear.
You know what, Mr. Black? I think you and your pet should take your deal up your asses. We can do it on our own.
Come on, guys. It's not like we get a deal like this every single day. We should take it.
We really need this.
Okay, no. Listen, ladies, I'm quite happy right here where I am. So Mr. Fancy over there can take his deal and shove it up in.
Anna, the people you should focus on are out there. Let's go.
24 hours, ladies. 24 hours.
What do you think, sir?
We've got a problem. That's what I think. I mean, we're never going to get these girls to sign if only two of them are willing. And I do want them. I mean, if we at least get one more, with three against one, we'll have them. But I just don't know what we're going to do.
Hey, Mommy.
Oh, hey, Papi. How are you doing?
Oh, thanks. Oh, I've been sober the entire day. Don't you think I deserve a fix?
Excuse me, what? You always do this. You never have any cash on you.
Oh, come on. I just complimented your show, didn't I?
And you think that's all it takes? I'm not dealing with you right now.
I'm just kidding.
Listen to me, Carlos. I am sick and tired of your rehearsed compliments. It is always the same thing with you. I know that I'm going to make it big one day, but every single time we have this argument, I keep seeing how difficult that's going to be when you take my money for another damn fix.
Also, that's how it is. After me taking time off my grand sport, you, baby, I've been saying you a star. I guess I'm too low for you now.
Don't
touch me.
Prashant, get me a meeting with that man.
profession is.
Oh, I know very well what my profession is. And stop being so melodramatic. This is show business. We all pretend to be things that we aren't. And you should stop pretending like those girls mean anything to you, other than the money that they bring into this place.
How dare you? That's not fair, and that's not why I brought these girls here. But you're right. This is show business. So how can you demonize me for making sure that my business runs smoothly?
Oh, so it's your business now?
You know I meant our business.
You definitely said my business, not our business. Am I right, Rashad? That's what she said. Or am I some sort of, I don't know, liar?
You know liar, sir. She definitely said my business.
Now remind me, Prashant, who was the one who came to me, begging me to get out of her deadbeat job?
That was her, sir.
And just remind me once more, Prashant, who was the one who single-handedly built and funded this entire establishment?
Now that was all you, sir.
Now, tell me, Lady Jasmine, whose business is this? Sorry?
It's your business.
That's right, Prashant, clap for her.
Thank you.
against a black guy.
With that rude prick. I'm not doing it, Carlos.
You've always dreamt of being famous, and now I'll provide you an opportunity and you say no. Why? Because he was rude to you? Come on, you want more than that.
Okay, fine. I'll do it. I'll call the girls.
Anything.
Thank you, Carlos.
Now give me a kiss. Another one.
Me.
suffice, but don't be worried. I'll deal with her later. Now there's a car waiting for you outside. Prashant, if you please. And oh, ladies, before I forget, I have a great feeling you'll be needing these.
Guys, wait. Do you really think Lady Jasmine is just on holiday? Don't trust him.
Ladies, I can assure you everything is above board. Prashant, thank you. You'll do best to learn and learn fast.
I didn't sign anything. I have a voice of my own. They don't speak for me.
But I think they do. You see, with three of them above board, it means that the contract is binding. 70%, 75% of them signed. So I own. What do I always say?
It takes a pretty special salesman to make people sell themselves, sir.
And I can assure you, I'm a unique salesman.
I'm not for sale.
But I think you are. You see, I found the other girl's weaknesses. Money, fame. Everyone has a weakness. That's why you work in this job. You think you do it for fun. No. You do it because you're arrogant! You think you're better than everybody else! But here's a trick, little girl. It doesn't matter who is better. It matters who is stronger! That's the way the world works, little girl. I own you. Like Lady Jasmine, like the other three girls. I own you.
Call the police!
Call the police! Yeah! Use my phone! Call them! What are you gonna try next, huh? Ready! Screaming! You think you're better? Look at me when I talk to you! You have no face! You have no name! You are mine! Pack up your shit! You're coming with me! You have 5 minutes!
Yeah.
I must say that, Selena, you look quite good. Last time I saw you, you were like a group hug. You look so nice and slender, eh? Yeah.
can I smoke in here?
Smoke? No, you can't smoke, but you can have a glass of wine.
Oh.
They're black. So I have permission to
controversial guest today. At this point in time, I would like to call on stage the Minister of Human Settlement, Mr. Patrick Barras. Let's welcome him. Let's give him a round of applause.
Okay,
Oh, I mean, hey, this news is not my type. What the hell? Hey, when the fish? Uzizo anjani? Ubulala umuntu. Hey, kahle kahle. Uzizo anjani? Ubulala umuntu omnyama.
Chief, what he's trying to say is that all you do. I'll tell you what it's like to kill a black at first. Adrenaline pumps through every vein, every single bone, every single muscle, every single thought. It's involved in that moment. I love my job. It takes a while to recover from. The man who served the state and just doing that job. Ladies and gentlemen, this is just for our great entertainment. I'll call the bad bitch, bad bed, as it's called, to come and give us a piece of entertainment. As I can see that, seems like these gentlemen are fighting. So just to come things down, we'll have a piece of entertainment of our show. Take us.
Shoot.